Hey, this is Alex coming at you from Hub City, Somerville. Today we're doing a review on the Nike SB Dunk Low Lunar East Coast. Man, I know we've been showing you guys a lot of black box Nike SB Dunks, but they're just the best. There's no comparing it. This is one of those shoes that's so timely and from that era, we have to give you guys a closer look. And it's unfortunate because you really will not find these brand new anywhere. Super, super hard to find. And I think in their own era were really sought after, so it adds up that they would be the way they are today. But it's super dope we get to give you guys a look. And getting into the shoe itself, the aesthetic, the inspiration. So they basically, and as I've said many times about the Black Box series, this is an era where they're giving you real themed sneakers, no gimmicks. And these were themed off of the lunar eclipse taking place that year on both the East and the West Coast, this pair being the East Coast. The leather uppers themselves, the leather almost shines, man. And this isn't cheap leather either. This isn't like it got sticky over time. I mean, it held really nice, really great chops of leather from this era. So the whole upper is different monotone shades, basically grayscaling from light gray to black. Contrast stitching really makes the shoe pop, and it's interesting because they basically contrasted the whole thing because it's black stitching on the back panel but white stitching on the toe on the side where the eyelets are. Dunks with the logo embroidered on the heel kind of became a staple for dunk collectors in the early era. So the Lunar East Coast and West Coast did really well, also because of the way that they were released. So this wasn't your typical skate shop release. Skate shops on the East Coast got the East Coast version, and shops on the West Coast got the West Coast version, which created a more desirability amongst the crowd. You know, if you had an East Coast pair, odds are you wanted to hunt down that West Coast pair just to have both. So I think that's what made these such a hot ticket item in their own era. The value of them was pretty much immediate because of what I had just said. So they resold for maybe $200 to $250 during that time. And today with the dunk market and the way it is now and the fact that there's no pairs dead stock available, you'll pay up to $1,000 for a brand new pair. Even here we're charging $750, which believe it or not is incredibly fair given the state of the market today. The reaction and the overall perception of the shoe on both coasts, everyone loves them. And again, this was an era where people just really were eating dunks up. So it comes as no surprise that something like this with the heel counter embroidered, resold and did well. And I think me personally, I remember being a kid, like dreaming of finding this sneaker. Even now, bro, I would love a pair in a size 13 and 14, but I know it's not gonna happen for me unless they re-release them. So fingers crossed that Nike will start to re-release stuff that isn't just collaboratory, because this would be a great step in the right direction for the brand. Let us know what you guys think. Let us know if you think these are garbage or if you love them. Let us know your best box series. Please sound off in the comment section below. Please like and subscribe. Your viewership means the world to us. Thank you again for tuning in. Peace.